This is where China's future in the world is mapped out. The National People's Congress, or the NPC, is officially the highest organ of power in China, with nearly 3,000 delegates. Meets annually to outline the superpower's long-term plans. Here are the takeaways from this year's meeting. Top of the agenda was changes to Hong Kong's electoral system. The semi-autonomous, partially democratic region was a thorn in autocratic Beijing's eye for a while. Hong Kongers have long wanted an overhaul of their electoral laws, but in a direction opposite to what Beijing has imposed. For years, they have demanded universal suffrage with huge rallies seen in 2019. Beijing is now pushing back with a vote of 2,895 to zero. With one exception, NPC delegates approved a decision to amend the electoral clauses in Hong Kong's mini-constitution, although we don't have the details of the amendment yet. What we know so far has many alarmed. Under the new rules, the makeup of Hong Kong's mini-parliament, the Legislative Council, or the electoral, will change. Currently, the electoral is made up of 70 seats. 35 seats are directly elected by Hong Kongers, and 35 are filled mostly by pro-Beijing representative constituencies. The amendment will raise the number of seats from 70 to 90. It's still unclear who will fill these extra 20 seats, but many fear it will likely be pro-Beijing voices, further diluting the influence of Hong Kongers on how they are governed. And even the 35 seats that Hong Kongers get to choose directly have not been spared. If a Hong Konger was to run for one of these directly elected seats, they will now have to be vetted by a panel to make sure they are patriotic. It's not yet clear what qualifies as patriotic according to China, but senior officials said Hong Kong's elected public officers should have holistic love and loyalty to the country and to the leadership of the ruling party. Critics fear this means pro-democracy candidates, or ones that China disagrees with, will be disqualified from running for Hong Kong's Legislative Council. Many in the West are echoing this fear. The European Union has said the changes will have a significant impact on democratic accountability and political pluralism in Hong Kong. Chinese authorities have persistently emphasized that their definition of democracy is different from that of many people in Hong Kong. For now, it seems that the China's definition is what Hong Kongers will have to live with. Another item on the National People's Congress agenda was China's economic future. China was the first country in the world to report COVID-19 cases. The pandemic has severely hit its economy. In 2020, the economy grew by a meagre 2.3%, the slowest growth rate in over four decades. For 2021, China is aiming for more than 6% growth. It's a rather conservative target compared to market expectations. But Chinese Premier Li Keqiang doesn't think his country is aiming low. A cornerstone for China's economic ambitions is competitiveness against its biggest rival, the United States. Beijing has laid out steps to shift its reliance on foreign trade for industrial production to domestic consumption, especially homegrown technology. China plans to boost its investment in technological research and development by 10% this year and more than 7% during the next 5 years. Core technologies like semiconductors, artificial intelligence, and military science are the main areas for that investment. At the same time though, China is ramping up control over its domestic tech giants like Alibaba, which are criticized by the authorities as monopolies. Alibaba's fintech company Ant Group, tipped as the world's biggest IPOs last year, was blocked from listing right before its launch due to Chinese regulators' anti-monopoly investigation. That came after Alibaba's founder Jack Ma's outspoken comment against Chinese regulatory policy. Recently, 12 more leading tech firms were fined under the anti-monopoly law. Beijing is planning to continue enacting new rules to intensify scrutiny of the tech industry. It claims to promote fair competition and curtail unregulated expansion of capital. Striking a balance to counter both foreign and domestic tech forces will be Beijing's ongoing challenge, also a key issue closely watched around the world. Military spending also took center stage at this year's MPC. China is increasing its defense budget by 6.8% to $210 billion in 2021, despite high government debts. China's military spending is the second highest in the world behind the United States. Beijing has insisted that the figures are transparent, despite long-standing skepticism. During the MPC, Chinese President Xi Jinping said that China faces a rising, unstable, and uncertain security situation. She didn't specify, but China has been nervous about military disputes on several fronts, ranging from South China Sea, India to Taiwan. He said the army must be ready at all times and build up war preparedness. China's five-year plan will implement measures to modernize its military by 2027, including upgrading weapons and focusing more on disruptive technology. 2021 is a landmark year for Chinese Communist Party as it will soon turn 100 years in July. In China, an anniversary like that means absolutely no tolerance for failure.